Okay. I didn't just disappear from YouTube for 2 years. I nearly deleted everything. And I mean everything. It's not an exaggeration. And I'll go into more detail. So the last video I made was me asking you for questions, and I was going to compile those questions and make a Q&A video. But so many people were asking me specifically about where I've been over the last 2 years and what I've been doing that I felt like it was enough for me to make an individual video based on it. So it's true when I said that over the last 2 years, I haven't just disappeared, but I've very nearly deleted everything. YouTube videos, nearly deleted. YouTube channels, nearly deleted. Twitch, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Discord, you name it, I nearly deleted it. And when I say nearly deleted it, I mean literally finger hovering over the delete button on this YouTube channel numerous times. I spoke to my brother, I spoke to the woman, and they both gave me the same advice, which was, don't do that, that's a stupid thing to do. Take some time off. So I did. I took a month off and then felt exactly the same. So then I took a year off and I felt a lot better. It then took me another further year to make the first video, which was the last video I made on this channel. Something that I've never spoken about publicly, but I think it's justified in this instance to finally come clean, which is I have been very well known for disappearing on YouTube for numerous occasions. I'll make a video and a content schedule, and then I'll disappear. And then I'll come back and disappear. And it comes across as quite bad on my part, because it looks like, oh, he's disappeared because, you know, he's lazy, or he's fallen out of love with YouTube, or he's not interested anymore, or other reasons, which may play into a small fraction of that, but it's not the real reason. The real reason why I always disappear from YouTube is because I have an issue with my mental health that manifests in debilitating states of being, I suppose is the best way to describe it. Either depressive episodes or burnout episodes or another thing which I'm not going to go into. I go through these cyclical periods of me really struggling mentally with them. And it's not that I want to go away from YouTube. It's that I just do, because my brain won't allow anything else. And then I get better. And then I go into the routine, and then I chomp it down a little bit. And then bam, it happens again. For the first time in my life, 2 years ago, I was able to recognize the symptoms that I was just about to go into one of these spirals, and I was able to take preventative measures to stop that from happening, and I successfully did. So 2 years ago, I was just about to fall into a crisis, and I managed to prevent it. So a few of you are asking about what the most exciting and interesting things I did over the last 2 years, what were the biggest letdowns. So easily, the most exciting thing was the fact that the woman and I are still doing great. We got engaged and we're getting married at the end of this year. We also bought this house. We've been living in it for a few years now and we bought it off our landlords. I also have done a number of good things in these years, and very few bad things have happened to me. It's been a good 2 years. Been pottering around in the garden, been renovating the house. I've closed down some companies, which could look like a bad thing, but it was really good because it was a lot of cognitive load just lifted off my brain. So when somebody asked me about how did the app go, Clipshare was one of those companies. We were going to be making a product for YouTubers in order to help clip their content and share it on social media, all in the same platform. But because of team dynamics and team decisions and stuff, we were a founding company of four, but then that whittled down to just two of us, me and my friend Dan. And yeah, that litigation period lasted so long that I ran out of money and had to find employment elsewhere or make some really quick cash in Clipshare. My other company closed down as well, but that was just a media agency that was filming events and doing live streams for other people. And considering that I was also not wanting to do YouTube content, I decided to close that down as well. And that was a good thing. Both of those companies closing was a good thing. So I understood that I needed a job and I needed routine and I needed to be around people. So when somebody asked me about working for this digital product studio that I'm currently working at and why, that was one of the reasons. I needed routine, I needed to work with good people, and I needed to work with something that I enjoyed doing. And the tech community in Cornwall is something that I'm familiar with. So I work for a company, it's a digital product studio called High Yield. We're based here in Cornwall. And yeah, I work, at first I worked in the sales and marketing department, a little bit of business development, but I stepped away from marketing and now I work in sales, project management, and account management. I really enjoy it. The people are good. Even the clients are good, which is great. There are some things about working for a company which is a bit of an issue for me, but that's just me, not the company itself. So yeah, that's basically where I've been and what I've been doing. Somebody else did ask me why I was away for so long and if I learned anything. And there are a number of things that I've learned about being away, which I will make a separate video on. As for the other questions I was asked, you know, there's a bunch of questions that people ask me about lucid dreaming and things like that, which I will answer, and questions specifically about me and also new content things. So I will probably break those up into subsequent videos as well. Did I just record all of this in one take? Pretty cool. Thank you for being so patient with me over the last 2 years. Honestly, it's awesome. I am back, but don't expect regular uploads. I will explain more in the next video. Bye. I got to crawl all the way over to turn off the camera.